section in your syllabus is electron spin and the postulates of spin. First of all, we have to discuss what is electron spin. We know that a single electron is not completely represented by the wave function psi r. That is, the psi r is characterized by three quantum numbers, that is principal quantum number, asymmetrical quantum number and magnetic quantum number. That is, even in a state with no orbital angular momentum, the application of an magnetic field reveals that the psi is a doublet. To explain the occurrence of the doublet, Goldschmidt and Uhlenbeck suggested that an electron can spin its own axis. That is, an electron always spin on its axis either in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. And this is called a spinning motion of the electron. Due to this spin motion, it can have an intrinsic angular momentum and it is called spin angular momentum. It is also associated with a magnetic moment value. Like the mass and the charge of the electron, the spin angular momentum quantum number value has a specific value, that is, it cannot be increased or decreased. The total angular momentum of an electron is made up of the contributions from its orbital and spin motions, that is, orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. Just as orbital motion gives rise to orbital magnetic moment, the spin motion gives rise to spin magnetic moment. Early evidence for the electron spin came from the experiment of Stern and Gerlach. They used silver atoms as projectiles in their experiment and they obtained two bands. And these bands corresponded to the L value of 1 by 2. This result is contradictory to the fact that the total orbital angular momentum quantum number L must always be 0 or an integer. That is, they obtained the value 1 by 2. That is, it is a half integer. Later, the same experiment with the normal silver atoms revealed that the total orbital angular momentum of the electrons in a closed shell added up to 0, so that the single valence electron in the S level has no orbital angular momentum since its value of L is equal to 0. This means that the splitting of a beam of silver atoms into two distinct beams does not arise from the orbital angular momentum but only from the spin angular momentum. Based on this experiment, two important results are obtained. First one, the fact that the two bands are obtained indicates that the total spin angular momentum quantum number is 1 by 2. The second one is, one beam is deflected as though each atom in it has a z component of magnetic moment mu z of plus beta e and the other mu z has a value of minus beta e. This result can be interpreted as follows. Suppose we assume that the laws of spin angular momentum are similar to that of orbital angular momentum. First of all, we have to differentiate these two. Let us represent the spin angular momentum quantum number as S instead of L and the spin magnetic quantum number as MS instead of ML. Then we can relate mu z spin is proportional to mz spin. The relationship between mu z and mz is given by mu z spin, that is equal to g into e divided by 2mc into mz spin. Here g is a constant. That is, mu z spin, that is equal to g into gamma e into mz spin, where gamma e, that is equal to e divided by 2mc into beta e divided by h cross, that is gyromagnetic ratio, or g, that is equal to g into beta e divided by h cross into mz spin, where the value of beta e, that is equal to e into h divided by 4 pi mc. But we know that the z component of spin motion, that is mz, that is equal to ms h cross. Since s is equal to 1 by 2 by the experiment, ms is equal to plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2. So mz spin, that is equal to plus or minus 1 by 2 h cross. Substituting these values in the equation for mu z spin, we get mu z spin, that is equal to g into e divided by 2mc into plus or minus 1 by 2 h cross, that is equal to plus or minus 1 by 2 g beta e. Experimentally, mu z, that is equal to plus or minus 1 by 2 beta e. This means that the value of g is equal to 2, and the g is called the Landé splitting factor for an electron. Recent dimensions have shown that the value of g is equal to 2.002319. Similarly, for the total magnetic moment due to the spin, we can write the following equations. Mu spin, that is equal to g into e divided by 2mc m spin, that is equal to g into gamma e into m spin, that is equal to g into beta e divided by h cross into m spin. Here m spin is the spin angular momentum, and it is given by m spin, that is equal to root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into h by 2 pi. Also mu spin, that is equal to g into e divided by 2mc into m spin. From these equations reveals the following facts. As the electron is negatively charged, the spin magnetic moment vector mu and the spin angular momentum vector m point in the opposite directions. The orbital magnetic moment is obtained by multiplying the orbital angular momentum by e divided by 2mc, but the spin magnetic moment is obtained by multiplying the spin angular momentum by g into e divided by 2mc, that is e by mc. That is the ratio between the orbital magnetic moment and the orbital angular momentum is gamma e, called gyromagnetic ratio. It is equal to e by 2mc, but the relation between the spin, that is the ratio between the spin magnetic moment and spin angular moment, is e by mc. That is, the gyromagnetic ratio for spin motion is twice as large for the orbital motion. This Stern-Gerlach experiment is a direct measurement of the electron's intrinsic magnetic moment, that is mu spin. The value of mu spin can be calculated as mu spin, that is equal to root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into h by 2 pi into g into e divided by 2mc. On rearranging this, that is root 3 into h e divided by 4 pi mc, that is equal to root 3 into beta e, that is root 3 Bohr magneton. There are some other evidences for this electron spin, and they are obtained from the ESR and NMR spectroscopy, and also the degeneracy of the excited states of the atoms and the molecules, and the anomalous Siemen effect, and the fine structure of the splitting of atomic spectra. And these experimental facts reinforces this electron spin nature. Later, Dirac has shown that if Schrodinger wave equation is recast in a form so as to satisfy the requirements of the relativity theory, its solution leads to directly to the fourth quantum number due to the electron spin. Next, you have to study the quantum mechanical treatment of electron spin. In quantum mechanics, first we set up the operators for angular momentum and energy. That is, first we write the Hamiltonian. For that, first we write down the classical mechanical expression for them, then replace this classical mechanical expression in terms of quantum mechanical operators, appropriate quantum mechanical operators. After setting up these appropriate quantum mechanical operators, one can derive the commutation rules, eigenfunctions and eigenvalues corresponding to that system. Such a procedure cannot be adopted to set up the spin operators. and their commutation rules, spin eigenfunctions and spin eigenvalues. This is because there is no classical analog of the electron spin. Therefore, it is necessary to introduce the spin concept in the form of postulates of spin. There are different postulates of spin. First one is the first postulate. The operators for spin angular momentum commute and combine in the same way as that of the operators of orbital angular momentum. Similar to that of orbital angular momentum, we can write the spin angular momentum. Square of the spin angular momentum is represented by S square, and its x, y and z components are represented by Sx, Sy and Sz. Therefore, we can write S square, that is equal to Sx square plus Sy square plus Sz square, and the commutation relation between Sx, Sy, that is equal to Sx, Sy minus Sy, Sx, that is equal to I into H cross into Sz. Similarly, the commutation relationship between Sy, Sz, that is equal to I into H cross into Sx, and the commutation relation between Sz and Sx, that is equal to Sz, Sx minus Sx, Sz, that is equal to I into H cross Sy. The operators for spin angular momentum components do not commute with each other. However, they commute with the square of the spin angular momentum, that is S square. Therefore, we can write Sx into S square minus S square into Sx, that is equal to 0, and also Sy square minus S square Sy, that is equal to 0, and Sz square minus S square Sz, that is equal to 0. As a result, we can conclude that it is possible to specify precisely the total spin angular momentum and any one of its component only at the same time. For a system consisting of many electrons, we can set up the operators for total spin angular momentum as Sg square, Sxt, Syt and Szt. Here the Sg square, that is equal to Sxt square plus Syt square plus Szt square, and also the value of Sxt, that is equal to sigma Sxi, Syt, that is equal to sigma Syi, Szt, that is equal to sigma Szi, and also we note that the Sg square, that is not equal to sigma Si square. And this follows from the fact that Sg, that is equal to sigma Si, that is equal to sigma Sxi plus Syi plus Szi. Sg, that is equal to Sxt plus Syt plus Szt. Therefore, Sxt, that is equal to sigma Sxi, Syt, that is equal to sigma Syi, Szt, that is equal to sigma Szi. Their commutation relations are Sxt, Syt minus Syt, Sxt, that is equal to I into H cross into Szt, Syt, Szt minus Szt, Syt, that is equal to I into H cross into Sxt, and also finally Szt, Sxt minus Sxt, Szt, that is equal to I into H cross into Syt. The components of the total spin angular momentum operator commute with its squares, that is Sg square, that is Sxt, Sg square minus Sg square, Sxt, that is equal to 0. Similarly, Syt, Sg, and Szt and Sg, that is equal to 0. Commutation relations are equal to 0. The second postulate, it is based on the Stern-Gerlach experiment, which shows that the z component of the spin angular momentum of a single electron in the valence shell of the silver atom can have only two possible eigenvalues, that is plus or minus 1 by 2 H cross. This means that for a single electron, there are only two eigenfunctions for the Z component of angular momentum, spin angular momentum Szz. That is, as Szz and S square commute, they have the same set of two eigenfunctions. This second postulate may be stated as follows, that is, for a single electron, there are only two spin functions for Szz and S square, and these are represented as alpha omega and beta omega. Just as we have used r theta and phi to represent the position variable, that is the configuration of a system in space, In the case of spin, we are using the spin variable omega in order to represent the spin space. As there are only two possible spin states, alpha and beta, the spin variables can assume only two different values corresponding to different orientations of the spin. An electron in the state alpha is said to have its spin angular momentum vector pointing up with respect to the reference axis, say it is an z axis. By this sign convention, for the angular momentum vector, the state alpha corresponds to the clockwise spin anti-clockwise spin motion. The z component of spin angular momentum for this anti-clockwise spin motion, that is anti-clockwise orientation of the spin angular momentum vector, has the magnitude equal to root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into h cross, that is equal to plus 1 by 2 h cross. The spin state alpha is characterized by the spin angular momentum quantum number s, or it is the called simply spin value of is equal to 1 by 2, and a spin magnetic quantum number, it is called simply called ms, that is equal to plus 1 by 2. It is represented by alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2. An electron in a state beta is said to have its spin angular momentum vector pointing down with respect to the reference z axis. This state corresponds to the clockwise motion of the electron. The z component of the spin angular momentum for this orientation of the spin angular momentum vector has the magnitude root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into h cross, that is equal to minus 1 by 2 h cross. For this state, the s is equal to 1 by 2 and ms is equal to minus 1 by 2, and it is represented by beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. The two spin states are shown in the following figure. Sign up for spin up for alpha spin, spin down for beta spin. This is spin up for anti-clockwise direction and spin down for clockwise direction. These two states are degenerate. In presence of a magnetic field, the degeneracy is lifted. That is why the ms is called spin magnetic quantum number. Usually this spin state ms with plus 1 by 2 is represented by an upward arrow, and the state ms with minus 1 by 2 is represented by a downward arrow. Their representations alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2 and beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is similar to the representations of the eigenfunctions of L square and Lz as the eigenvalues of alpha and beta, and they are given by S square into alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into S cross square alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2. The second one, S square beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into S cross square into beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. SZ alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2, that is equal to plus 1 by 2 H cross alpha 1 by 2 1 by 2. SZ beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, that is equal to minus 1 by 2 H cross beta 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. The third postulate of spin. This postulate is also based on the Stein-Gerlach experiments. It states that spinning of the electron acts like a magnet, and the magnitude of this is given a magnetic dipole moment, and its value is given by mu, that is equal to g into e divided by 2mc into root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into h by 2 pi. On rearranging this, we can write root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 into g into h e into 4 pi m into c, or that is equal to root of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus into g into beta e, where g is the Landé splitting factor for the electron. And the only possible value of the Lz component of this dipole moment mu z are plus or minus beta e. References: Fundamentals of Quantum Chemistry, R. Anantharaman, Macmillan India Limited, New Delhi.